You reduce radar by actually absorbing it into the very leading edge of it.
There's a specialized coating, a paint, if you will, that's painted on the aircraft. It is electrically conductive. It helps disperse the energy across the aircraft, along the trailing edges and the leading edges of the aircraft. Basically, the front of the wing and the end of the wing is a radar absorbing structure. It helps absorb the radar. Now, some of the other characteristics of LO is going to be, of course, the shape. The airplane is designed to have a low profile in the sky to look like just a line, harder to detect from far away. The color is designed primarily for night to make it harder to see during night missions, although it can fly during the day and do bombing missions. The engines are placed further down into the body of the aircraft to reduce the noise. And it also has an exhaust system, if you will, a giant muffler to make it harder to hear. If the airplane can be seen by a heat source, like take for example an F-15 with afterburner, it's like having a big giant flashlight in the sky. This airplane is designed to lower the heat coming off of the back of the engines. There's some tiles on the back of the aircraft that are basically the same thing that's used on the space shuttle. If you were to take one of those tiles, put it in an oven, get it glowing red, by the time you pull it out of the oven, it's going to be cool to touch. That's how well it disperses heat.
All right, this is the B-2 leading edge. It's got a lot of functions, but one of the main functions is the coatings that are on it are actually elastic, or kind of rubbery, if you will, because if they ever run through a hailstorm or anything such as that, the hail will just bounce right off of it, and it won't affect the coatings too bad. There are several types of coatings on it. The most important coating would be the conductive coating, and because it also absorbs the radar and disperses the radar through the entire jet.
This aircraft, unique to other aircraft, is when it's in flight, everything is completely flush with the surface of the aircraft. For example, this trapezoid figure you can see right here is actually one of the lights, and it drops out from the bottom of the aircraft so the aircraft can be seen at night. But when it goes into flight and it's going over a hostile area, that light is retracted. Now, not only do the lights come in and out, there's also different antennas and part of the radar that can become flush. All the doors also close flush with the surface of the aircraft. Not only does it help with the smoothness of the aircraft flying through the air, but it also has a lot to do with the actual conductivity of the aircraft, keeping it stealth.
The difference between the B-2 and other aircraft are all the trailing edge.
All of these surfaces you see right here that are bent at different angles have different reasons for being here as far as controlling the aircraft. The furthermost two right here, you can see one is hanging down, is actually the rudder of the aircraft. It helps it turn left to right. And then the three coming inboard from this right here, basically coming into the fuselage of the aircraft, are called elevons. They work either together or they can all be separate, and they help control the aircraft bank and turn and that kind of thing. This structure you can see right here, this is called the GLASS, which stands for the Gust Load Alleviation Surface, and it is all computer controlled. It actually flutters like a dovetail in the air as the airplane banks and turns and flies. It keeps it from basically falling out of the sky.
This is actually where all the weapons are stored, and this is where they drop from the aircraft. We can't actually look up in there, but that's where they do their damage, and that's where they come from.